Hi dear friends, today we are going to study the problem related to the mean sectional area method. In last video, we have already gone through the different methodologies used for the computation of the earthwork. Now in this video, we are going to study how to calculate earthwork quantity by using mean sectional area method. In last or previous video, we have already gone through the problem which was solved related to the mid-sectional area method. So in this particular video, we are going to see what exactly difference in both these methods are there and how to calculate the quantities with the mid-sectional area method. So for, as always I am saying, if you like the explanations and the content of this video, like to my video, and also you can subscribe to the channel for Tech Civil HOD CSMSS. So let us start with the today's problem, that is nothing but the calculate earthwork for roadwork for following given data. As earlier we have seen the mid-sectional area method computation, accordingly the same data I am using for this particular problem, so that we can get to know that what exactly difference in both these methodologies are there. So whatever RLs we have used for last problem, that is the same we are going to use over here. So RL of different chain edges are being mentioned in problem, and the station points are being mentioned this given data. Also formation width of the road is given, that is nothing but 10 meter, and side slopes is 2:1 in embankment, and 1.5:1 in cutting section. So these particular things are very important while calculating the side slopes, and that's why one should know or remember how much slope is given in embankment and how much slope is being used in cutting. So again, in addition to this, one more data is given, which is very important to be start with the problem. The RL of formation at starting point is 52 meters with a downward gradient of the 1:200. So this again, downward gradient means the slope of the road is towards downward, and hence the formation RLs will go on reducing if your chain edges are increasing. Means for 10,000, 1,000 chain edge, if it is 52, so it will go on decreasing towards the 1,400 chain edges. So these are the data given in our particular problem. So let's start with the answer. First and foremost step in this particular thing is that calculating the how much particular values will be get reduced from this formation level for each chain edges. So I will note down one more thing in answer, that as formation level is provided with a downward gradient of 1:200, and the chain, what is chain edge difference, because this value of chain edge difference is very much important to calculate the values to be reduced for formation levels. So I mentioned it over here, and let us find out the value by which formation we will get reduced. So gradient is 1:200 and chain edge difference is 40 meter, because for different kind of the problems or for different kind of the conditions, this chain edge difference could be different one and the gradient might be could different one, and that's why I have mentioned it over here. And now we are going to calculate how this, or why, by which value this formation level go on reducing. I am saying reducing because the downward gradient is there. If one is having rising gradient, then this value should be get added to the formation level. So the formula will becomes the difference of chain edges divided by the gradient value. That is 1:200 was there, therefore I have adopted here 200, and that chain edge difference was 40. That's why I have used 40 divided by 200, which is nothing but 0.2 meter. So after getting this value, we are supposed to prepare and this table where we are going to find out the depth or height. So first and foremost table is chain edge, the bottom one. Then after chain edge, we are putting the particular values, that is chain edge is mentioned over here. Then RL of the ground as mentioned in the given data we have written over here. And I have noted first of all RL of formation here, that is 52 meter. So only this RL of formation we were having with us in given data, and we were calculated by how much values we are supposed to go on reducing. So accordingly I have deducted 0.20 from this 52 and I got an 51.80 for second chain edge. Then accordingly for each chain edge I will go on reducing 0.20, and that's why 52, first one is 52, then 51.80, then 51.60. likely I will go up to the last chain edge point, that is 50.00 is the RL of formation. So after getting this formation RL or RL of formations, one can calculate the depth or height which is required to be used in calculation. So how to calculate this depth or height? As earlier I told you that during previous video that Albits try to use an unique formulation, because if you are using RL of formation minus RL of ground, then whatever sign convention we are getting, we can understand from that particular things that this plus sign values are having in embankments and negative sign depths or heights are nothing but in cutting. So now in this methods also, or in this particular problem also, I have deducted the value of RL of ground level from the RL of formation. So 52 minus 51 will nothing but 1. 51.80 minus 50.90, that is 0.9. accordingly I have calculated one by one and I have put it whatever the algebraic sign it comes after calculation. So we can understand that from 1000 chain edge to the 1200 chain edge, the value of all the depth or height was positive, and that's why these particular values or these particular sections up to 1200 meter chain edge is nothing but an embankment or the filling. And after 1240 up to the 1400 chain edge, we have got a negative signs for the depth or height, and that's why we can say that this particular chain edges are in cutting. So accordingly we can understand these particular things. So after getting these values, one should observe that where this positive and negative values are arise. So on 1200 it is 0.3 and 1240 it is minus 0.4. it means that from 1200 chain edge to the 1240, the value or the formation level is going on from filling to the cutting. And for that reason we have added one more step in this particular problem to come up with a clarification how these particular values to be calculated. So what I did, I have formulated one table over here which is we have prepared just right now, and marked all the data we have calculated over there and mentioned in this particular table. So accordingly what I will do, I will consider a datum line over here, and accordingly will mark and profile leveling for this particular table one by one. So these are the profiles of each chain edges according to the dimension. In this particular problem I have considered the datum of 145 meter. So accordingly dimension whatever I have read, I have marked an all profile and mentioned this particular profiling. So as after getting this particular profile leveling, I will mention now formation level. So on first chain edge, that is 1000 meter chain edge, the formation level was at 52 meter. So I will mark that particular value, and on 1400 chain edge it was 50 meter. So I will mark that point and I will join this particular level and mention the formation level was 1 in 200, and this was the formation level line we have getting over here. Now from this particular line we can understand that this particular values, that is filling is here and in this location cutting is there. So from this particular figure one can understand at which location, means 1200 to 1240, the formation level crosses from filling to the cutting, and that where it exactly crosses we are supposed to calculate. And for that purpose we have drawn this particular figure of 1200 to 1240 chain edge cross section. So over here we are having on left hand side at 1200 chain edge the value of 0.3, and at 1240 we were having 0.4 meter. So I mentioned it and marked the distance from 1200 to the point of zero, or the point at which from filling to cutting formation level is going. So I mentioned it as a X, and as the total dimension was 40 meter, so I had taken this as a 40 meter and calculated the remaining dimension, that was nothing but 40 minus X. So by using this particular relations of the triangle, we can create or we can use a formula that 0.3 divided by X, that is equal to 0.4 divided by 40 minus X. And by elaborating or by solving this equation, a this formula, we will get and these values, and by solving these particular values step by step, one can calculate the value of x, which is nothing but x is equals to 12 divided by 0.7, and this will becomes as 17.14 meter. It means that from 1200 meter to 17.14 meter, it means that 1217.14 meter is the point where the filling filling got transferred to the cutting, and that's why these particular values we are going to use in table now. So what I will do is that I will put that particular chainage additionally in the chainages, because at that particular location my depth will be zero. So after mentioning all the chainages including that particular zero level, zero depth point, so all the chainages I have marked in my table. Again, this table is particularly for mid sectoral area method. The one, if we observe clearly that in previous method of mid sectoral area method, we were having an particularly the depth, after depth we were having the mean depth, and accordingly we were calculated these values. This is the last previous problem which we have calculated, and after this particular thing we are not now going to check how the quantities can be calculated in mean sectional area method, because comparison we are doing. So just look after this table, how mid sectional area method we have used and what are the different things we are going to do now in mid mean sectional area method. So this is the second method we are going to use, that is mean sectional area method. So look at this table. The after depth or height, the third column was mean depth in previous methodology, but over here as we are going for mean sectional area method, the mean depth column is not being there. Instead of that, we are using mean sectional area method, and that's why one column has got added, that is mean sectional area method. So what I will do is that again, previously solved problem we have taken the chainages, same chainages we are going to take over here. The depths whatever we have calculated in the previous table I have taken over here as it is, and now when we are going for calculation of the area of central portion, that is B into D, we will multiply by the formation width to the depth whatever we have got right now, and that's why 10 multiplied by 1, that is 10, 10 into 0.9, that is 9, and accordingly I will calculate each and every values for all the depths by multiplying with the formation width, and these are the values whatever we have got over here. So now let's go for next step, that is calculation of the SD square. Again, in this particular thing, up to the embankment or filling we were having a sloping slope, side slope of the 2:1, and that's why I have used the S as 2 and D as we have got in second column. So S is 2 multiplied by 1 square, that is nothing but 2. Again, 2 into 0.9 square, that is 1.62, and one by one I will calculate up to the 1217.14 by using S as a 2, and from 1240 to 1400 meter chainage I will use S as 1.5, as the slope for cutting is 1.5 or 1 and 1 half as 2, 1 is the slope given, and that's why 1.5 into D square whatever we are having in our second column. So let's add these both the columns, that is BD and SD square, which will nothing but total sectional area. So I will add 10 plus 2, that is 12, 9 plus 1.62 as 10.62, and accordingly I will add one by one these both the columns and will mark as a total sectional area in the fifth column. So up to this the procedure is somewhat use the D directly and calculate BD, SD square and calculate the total cross sectional area method. Now in this method, as we are going to use mean sectional area method, so now we are going to use the mean of the areas, and that's why what I did, I taken average of the 12 and 10.6, which is nothing but 11.3, which can be calculated by 12 plus 10.6 and whole divided by 2. That means that 22.6 divided by 2, that will give me the 11.3. Then next, the 10.6 plus 13.4 divided by 2 will becomes 12, and accordingly one by one we have calculated the mean area for all the values whatever we have got in the fifth column, that is total sectional area. After getting this mean sectional area, one should take or calculate the length between the station. Again, this length can be calculated by taking the difference of the chain edges, succeeding chain edges, as 1000 minus or 1040 minus 1000, that is nothing but 40. 1080 minus 1040 is nothing but 40. So accordingly, one by one, we have calculated all these values or chain edges one by one and put it as a length in this particular column. So now I got a length mean sectional area, and now it is time to calculate the quantity by calculating mean area into the length. That is nothing but 11.3 multiplied by 40 will gives me the value of 452. 12 multiplied by 40 will gives me the 481. 10.1 multiplied by 40, that is 403. 6.72 into 40, that is 269. So these all values have been calculated by using Excel sheet. So the point you might not get exactly at this particular columns, but whenever you are calculating the values by using CalC, in points you will get and these values, and after these values, as these all the values were in embankment or filling, and that's why up to the 1217.14 I have entered all these values into the embankment, and for whatever values now from 1240 to 1400 I will multiply mean sectional area into the length and will enter these all the values into the cutting. So accordingly, these all the values or the quantity of excavation is been calculated and marked wherever it is required according to the calculation. So these all embankment and cutting we have entered in this particular table, and now it is time to calculate the quantity, total quantity for embankment and total quantity for cutting. So after adding the all values present in the column of embankment, we will get a value of 1830.30 cubic meter for embankment and near about 1389.463 cubic meter in cutting. So after calculating these all the values, one should represent or one should mention it separately, that what is the quantities you have calculated in embankment and what is the quantity calculated in cutting. So that's why I have mentioned it separately over here, that the quantity of embankment is nothing but 1830.30 and cutting value or cutting quantity of cutting is 1389.463. So accordingly, we can solve or we can use this mean sectional area method to calculate the quantity of earthwork in excavation, and we can calculate by using the mean sectional area method. So this is the method used for the mean sectional area method. So we can use this methodology to calculate the quantities by mean sectional area method. So hope you have understand all these things or all these methodologies, how to calculate the quantities and how to use the both methods, that is mean sectional area method and mean sectional area method. So you can like my video and you can also subscribe to my channel, that is Tech Civil HODCSMSS, and also put your feedbacks related to the subject and related to the upcoming videos, whatever you require. So thank you very much for watching my video. Thank you.